The Health Ministry is set to give out free HIV testing kits to a targeted population of over 5 million people. These will include youth aged between 15 and 24 years, sex workers, border riders, fishing communities, and long-distance truck drivers. The campaign will be launched tomorrow at Kololo Ceremonial Grounds in Kampala, with President Yoweri Museveni presiding over the event. The program officer of the AIDS Control Program in the Health Ministry, Dr. Christine Katusime, said the kits, which will be available in all government health facilities, are 100% accurate and give results within 15 to 20 minutes. She also shared more guidelines on how best to use the kits and seek guidance.
In the training, we are emphasizing to the VHTs that when they give the kit, for example, to a border man or to a pregnant lady to take to her spouse or her partner, then she is mandated to share with the spouse or the partner to use the kit within 7 days usage. But the shelf life is pretty long, so there will be a follow-up process after those 7 days to find out what the result was. If I find out within those 7 days that you've used the kit and it is a negative, I will be able to support you appropriately. If it's a positive, I can also support you appropriately. However, we are discouraging getting the kit and keeping it. So that's why we are giving it that period of 7 days.
The program will be implemented in 46 districts in a year, with a focus on health center twos and threes, as well as communities. Self-testing services will reach over 1,400 sub-counties, 190 town councils and townships, 7,500 parishes, 58,000 villages, and 30 learning sites on lakes in Uganda. The first Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of East African Affairs, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, has urged Busoga residents to embrace the presidential skilling hubs. She said the hubs will solve unemployment in the region and the rest of the country. She made the call at Busoga Zonal Presidential Industrial Hub in Jinja City while passing out 456 youth after vocational skills training.
Ndikwenda kutwala mukisa guno okwebaza eno President Yoweri Museveni olw'ensonga eno eya skilling abaana. We twaliteesa ku hubs zino, waliwo twali mu kabineti batandika okuripootinga hub eno yawa eno yawa eno yawa. Najo kubuza nti aye nga Busoga tuyigiwulira wakati Busoga ekalikuwa kuba nali kwenda kubawo nga baliyigulawo wakati ya Busoga ekalikuwa aye yamala yawa mwatandika era nsanga olukubona nti tufunye abaana bangi abakuguike. Ndikwenda kwebaza Engineer Raymond.
The former Speaker of Parliament and Kamuli District One Member of Parliament congratulated the graduates and pledged her support to all the proposals by the State House Comptroller and her team that are in line to further the President's skilling program. She was also happy to hear girls were interested in male-dominated courses.
Almost gender balanced. Natural labor processing. Mrada yenka, but it's one of our everybody's. It takes us to a mentality, I fear. Unmoga welding, Kadmuruga Basada. I am Saba Kobe. At Waka Impera no welding. Sundukanok Saba Zaire, take out your Masomo Gavarenzi, Namasomo Gavara. Amasomo Gonagona, Avana Bagasomi.
The trainees from 11 districts of Kamuli, Iganga, Bujiri, Mayuge, Jinja, Luka, Bugweri, Buyende, Kaliro, Namutumba, and Namayingo completed their vocational training and were awarded certificates in 7 disciplines. These included bakery and confectionery, tailoring and design, hairdressing and makeup, building and concrete practice and carpentry, and joinery, welding, and metal fabrications, as well as leather processing. The government has revealed that rehabilitation of the railway line from Namanve to Mukono is on track. This is being done in a bid to reduce traffic on the roads and ease the transportation of goods for traders. This was revealed by Jeno Katumba Wamala, the Minister of Works and Transport, adding that this is in line with government's plan to improve water, railway and road transport.
It's actually the whole idea behind is to reduce on the traffic jam, especially on Jinja Kampala Road, the section between Kampala and Namam. That's the one we are addressing now. But our view is that they are now constructing Namam to Mukono Street. So eventually it will be Kampala to Mukono to Kampala. When we are satisfied with that section, then we shall also take the Chengera route so that it's also done.
The minister added that companies that use the railway to transport their goods have been struggling, which has prompted them to expedite the works. Last year, the Uganda Railways Corporation closed a section of Kampala-Mukono railway line to passengers and cargo for 6 months to enable reconstruction works. The development affected an estimated 1,400 passengers who use these services.